In this video, I wanted to take a look at creating a very basic filter in Substance Designer that you can use here in Painter. Now, this was a question that was asked on our forums, and the user was painting height information. So here I have just a standard layer, and I have one of our alphas here set in the height channel, and I'm just going to stamp this height information down. Now, what they were wanting to do was, can I also utilize this height information that here was already placed in my layer stack? Can I use that as a mask? So for instance, where I've stamped, I'd also like to be able to kind of darken the color below that. And so is there a way that we can use this data here, this height information, as a mask? Well, there's not a way to do that specifically here inside of the Substance Painter UI. However, you can create yourself a custom filter that gives you this functionality, and we would do that with Substance Designer. And that's going to be the focus of today's video. We're just going to walk through a very simple way of doing this. So now we're going to jump over to Designer and just create this filter. Okay, so let's start by just going to File, New Substance, and here I'm going to use this Painter Filter Generic Template, and this is just going to give me a single output. And here we'll just call this mask_demo for our graph. Now let's click OK, and this is going to generate here our graph, and you can see that we have an input and an output. And the way this works in terms of creating a filter in Painter, if we look at this input here, this is going to represent data coming in from the layer stack. And then here in this middle area is where we would do any type of manipulation or augmentation to this data. And then here in the output, this is then going to be fed back out to the layer stack. So for this first input, what we want to do is grab the height information that we painted inside of Substance Painter. So for the usage, let's click this Add Item button. And here we're going to set this to height. So I just need to grab height. I'm just going to copy that value and we'll paste it in the identifier, and then we'll just paste it here into the label. So there's our height, and this output here is actually going to end up being our base color because with the height, we don't want to output height information again back out because we're going to keep that data inside the layer stack itself. We just want to take the height data and make a mask out of it. So this output here is going to end up becoming our base color. So let's go ahead and set it up while we have it here. So select, and let's do base color. We'll copy this here. Let's just paste it in the identifier, and then again, paste it in the label. So there's our base color. Now, since for this demonstration, what I'm wanting to do is use the height, create a mask, and then I'm going to use that mask to control a gamma adjustment. So, and I want to do this just on the base color. So I'm going to hit the space bar here, and I'm going to grab this input color, because I want to grab the color data, again, from the layer stack, and I want it to be the base color channel, and that's why we need this. So let's come over here to the usage, add item. Again, I already have this copied, so let's just paste in base color here, identifier, and label. So this is my base color input coming from the layer stack and my height from the layer stack. So what we're going to do now is generate a mask out of our height information that we painted. So that we can see kind of visually what we're doing, let me just grab a shape node here. And I'm going to set this to brick. And I'll adjust the scale. Let's just zoom out here. And then pattern specific. So we can see that, you know, there's some transitional gray values in here. We want to really sharpen up this mask area. So what I'm going to do is grab a levels. And I'll connect this guy in here. And then I'm just going to take my output black and just move it all the way up. And here I'll take my output white and push it towards the black. Here I'm just getting kind of a sharp mask here. Just a little bit of feather on the edge, but this is more of what I'm wanting to get here. And so this is what we're going to use for our mask. Now again, just for visual purposes, let's grab a uniform color. And we'll just set this to just some value. And we're going to use this to kind of demonstrate how our system's going to work. So what I'm going to do is grab a blend node here. Now, I want to do some type of gamma adjustment to the base color that's coming in from my layer stack, which again is just kind of represented right now with this uniform color. And we're going to use this mask here just to target a specific area. So what I'm going to do is, let's just pretend here that this uniform color is our base. So let's put this here into the background. So that's our background layer. And then we're going to do some type of gamma adjustment. So let's grab a levels here and let's plug this in. And this is going to be placed here on our foreground layer. Whoops. overwrote that there. Here we go. All right, so now I'm viewing this blend. So we go to our levels node and we adjust the gamma. And so now we're getting this gamma adjustment. Okay, so that's working so far. But we want to isolate it to a certain area, which is what we have here with our mask. So let's pull this here into the opacity. So again, let's see how this is working. We go to our levels and we adjust our gamma and perfect. So now we're just getting that gamma adjustment locked to a specific area based on our mask. So now we know that's going to work. And we also know that our control that we want to expose in Painter is just going to be this gamma. So to do that, we're going to click this values button. And here you can see that we have this level in mid control. And then we have these four sliders. Now we're going to want to adjust all of these guys to be the same value. If I just hit the function button and choose expose, and we'll just give it a generic input name for now, double click to go to my base layer and look at my level in mid, you can see that, well, in Painter, I'm going to have four separate controls. These controls, this is a vector four, so what this stands for is R, G, B, and A. And I'd have to manipulate all four of these guys separately just to get the value, and that's not really user-friendly. I'd really like just to have one slider. So let's set that up. Here I'm just going to kill this parameter, and I'll click this plus button to create a new one. And for this identifier, we're going to call it gamma. And this is going to be a float and a slider. And for the label here, we'll just call it gamma. And the default, I want it to be 0.5, so it won't have any effect. And I want to be able to move this from a minimum value of 0 and a maximum of 1, and then we'll clamp this value. So this is what I want to have, just a single slider control. So in order to actually get that to work now, we're going to have to rely on a function. So let's set that up. We're going to come over here to our levels, hit the values button again, and now here in this level in mid, I'm going to just clear this. So now we have our four controls, and then we're going to click the function button once more and choose empty function. And before we go into that, again, I just want to remind you that the data that we're working with here, we can see it here in the level in high as well. It's going to be four pieces of information. And so that is going to be a vector four. So that means that whatever this function is that we create, it has to output a vector four data type. So that's our goal. We need to create that. And that vector four just represents red, green, blue, and alpha here in Substance Designer. So first things first, let's go grab our user value. So spacebar, get float. And then we'll use the drop down here just to select that gamma value. So now we have our user control. So the next step is we want to just take this user value and just add it to the R, G, B, and A channels that we're going to output here to this gamma parameter. So we know that we just want to use the same value. Now the trick becomes, how do we construct this? So we have to manually construct this into that R, G, B, A data. And so the way we're going to do that is going to be through a stepped process. So first things first, let's start by just creating. So if we hit the space bar here, we're going to create, well, just to give you an example, you might think, oh, let's just do a vector float four. Oops, sorry, that was the get variable. Let's do this and do, let me just start to type vector, and we'll do vector float four. Well, you'll notice that there's only two inputs here. And these inputs are going to be vector twos here. So I can't just plug this in and plug this in. It's not going to give me the right values that I need. So we need to construct this. So in order to do that, this is going to be our final output. So let's just go ahead and keep that node there. Let's hit the space bar, and let's first create a vector float 2. All right, and this is going to represent our red and green channels. So we'll just plug the gamma and plug the gamma, and let's select the node, and we'll make a quick comment on this, and we'll just say this is R and G, so red and green. All right, now we have our red and green. We can now just easily just plug this guy in and plug this guy in. If we look at this float too, we would have R, G, B, and alpha all having the same gamma value. But I don't actually want to do that because I'd like to give the alpha a value of 1. So let's just take one more step before we create this. Let's hit the space bar this time and do a vector float 3. So this node here is just going to allow us to construct this vector containing three pieces of data. And so, well, with this vector float 2, we already have two pieces of that data, so that's great. We can plug that in. Now we just need one more piece. And in that case, we could just use a single float. So let's hit the space bar and do float. And actually, I'm sorry, we don't need the float. We want to use gamma again. So let's just plug this guy back in here. So what we have here is, or what we've done is we've constructed a vector 3 out of 3 pieces of data. We used our float 2 to get the 2 pieces, the red and green, and then for the blue channel, which is this second input, we're just using that float gamma again. So now with this guy, let's put a comment on it, we get RGB. So now we have all 3 channels. Now, the vector float 4 is going to work the same way as what we've done here with this vector 3. So we need to construct, you know, 4 pieces of data. Well, we already have 3 pieces here with this vector 3, so let's plug that in. Now, we just need the last one. Again, this vector 3 is going to represent our RGB. We just need the alpha. So now we'll hit the space bar, we'll do float, and I'm just going to set this to a value of 1. So now I'm getting my RGB is going to be this user-driven value, and then the gamma is always just going to be 1. So basically hard-coding that in. And so we'll grab this guy, and we'll hit the comment, and we'll just call this alpha. So there's our alpha information. Now that I've constructed the RGBA data is as a vector float 4, I can right-click this node, and it will allow me to set it as output. So we do that, and we get our output. All right, now let's go back to our graph and just test this guy. So we're going to go over here to our gamma, and you'll notice that as I start to move my slider, it's working. So one slider, or I could say one slider to rule all channels, basically. Okay, so we have that. Let's take this this color information that we have, and we're just going to plug this right here into our base color. All right, so that takes care of that. Now, we no longer need these little dummy visualization nodes, so let's delete these guys. Let's take this base color, which again is the data coming from our layer stack, and plug this here into the levels, and then plug this into our background. Now we'll take our height, and we'll plug this here into our levels. So this is going to take care of what we need to do. All right, so we have this. Let's double click, and let's make sure that we set this to be relative to parent for our main graph resolution, because again, we want that resolution to be set based on whatever the painter resolution or painter document resolution is. Okay, so we have this, and I'm going to save it. Here, I'm just going to save it on the desktop, just overwrite kind of what I had, and then I'll publish it as the SBSAR file. And now we're ready to use this in Painter. Okay, so here we are in Painter, and I've just imported in my substance here into this filters category, and doesn't generate a thumbnail for me. So if I wanted to, I could just right click and I could set a custom preview to this guy. And I think I have something here on the desktop I can use. We'll just do that. Okay, so there's just a little icon that I can use for this. So here's the layer that where I painted my height information. And what I'm gonna do is just click this button and add a filter. So now I can just take this filter and just drag and drop it here into the filter section. And so now you can see my little control is here. So what I can do is start to adjust my gamma. And you'll notice, well, nothing's happening, okay? So the reason for that is how we have our layer set up. Now in this particular case, and this is kind of the way I like to work, I'm using this layer, which here is my stroke layer, but there's no color into this. This was just my height information basically in this layer. So here, let's just name this height so we can see that visually. So this was just height information. There's no color in this. The color is actually coming from this fill layer or whatever, you know, information I have down here in this layer stack. So here, for example, let's just take this layer and just delete it. And this was a smart material. So here we had this smart material like this. And so what I would need to do is come back to this layer, and the layer, you can see that I have base color targeted. I'm going to set this mode here to pass through. And so what that means is it's going to take this data that's coming out of this substance filter, and it's going to pass it down through the layer stack. And that's what we want to do in this particular case. So here, now that I have this selected, this mass demo, I can adjust my gamma. And when I start to do that now, you can see that there it is. I'm adjusting gamma based on a mask that was derived from the data I painted here in my layer stack. And that gamma adjustment for my base color channel is now being passed down through the layer stack, as you can see here. So now, anytime I go to this layer, and here we'll go to our alphas, and let's just use a different, here we'll use this alpha now. And here in this case, you can see that I was also using that same height stamp for the alpha as well. So let's do that. Okay, so now I have this in place, and I'll come in and I'll stamp, and you can see that there you go, my gamma adjustment's already taking place for me as I work. So at any time, we can go back to this guy and adjust our gamma. So this has just been a very simple demonstration on how you can use Substance Designer to create filters to help you, which can be used to create tools that don't actually exist here in Painter. It's a very powerful in that you can, again, use Designer to extend the functionality of Substance Painter.